Hi guys, Nick Jennison for Guitar Interactive Magazine. On the test bench today, we're taking a look at two fabulous microphones from Ear Trumpet Labs. This is Louise and this is Myrtle. Now, those of you out there who are aware of my Geordie heritage must promise not to take the mick out of the way I say Myrtle. It's one of those words that's kryptonite for my people, but even still, these are fabulous, wonderful handmade microphones made in Oregon and the United States, and they look super retro, but they're actually very, very modern in terms of their performance. They're crazy low noise, really, really great feedback rejection, and they're intended to be used live, but they're also both large diaphragm condenser microphones that perform equally well on single sources, but also on ensembles. So if, for example, you had an acoustic ensemble with lots of singers, a bunch of different instruments, you could throw one of these microphones up and capture the whole ensemble. Alternatively, a pair of either one of these microphones will work wonderfully as drum overheads. You could use them as a vocal mic in the studio or for capturing pretty much any source with like really stunning accuracy and really great clarity and character, easy for me to say. Now, earlier on today, we took a trip down to my rehearsal space and we captured a few different sources using these microphones and a couple of industry standard mics as well. We're gonna begin by taking a listen to a mic'd guitar cabinet where we're gonna compare an SM57 to the Myrtle and the Louise. We'll also then compare a Beta 58 with the Myrtle and the Louise on a vocal to explore how well this pair of microphones would work as a live vocal mic. And lastly, we're going to compare both of these mics to a Rode NTA-1 on an acoustic guitar. But first of all, let's begin with a quick talk about the specifications and how these microphones work. As previously mentioned, they are both large diaphragm condensers, and because they are suspended in these lovely rings, which also give it a really cool aesthetic, I think they look fantastic. It's like something off The King's Speech or something like that, if you remember that movie. Really, really great looking mics. They have a really, really wide frequency pickup. This one, the Myrtle, is a little bit mellower sounding than the Louise, so this is a little crisper. It's perhaps going to capture high end on instruments like vocals, for example, or the strings on an acoustic guitar. By contrast, the Myrtle is just a little bit warmer, if that's the sort of thing you're looking for. Personally, I bonded with this one just a little bit more, but they both sound absolutely fantastic. They are going to need phantom power, and of course, an external phantom power box is available if you're going to use these with a combo amp, because that's something bluegrass guys do, which is very cool. So anyway, let's take a listen to our first example. We are going to take a listen to a mic'd guitar cabinet. We're going to use the same looped performance for every example, starting with an SM57. Then we'll take a listen to the Myrtle, and then we'll take a listen to the Louise. And just for reference, it's a Victory VX100 Super Kraken, the one you can see over my shoulder here, plugged into a Victory 4x12 with a Vintage 30 that we're currently miking. Let's take a listen to that now, and we'll compare how the three microphones sound. So while large diaphragm condenser mics might not be the obvious choice for micing guitar cabinet, let's not forget we are in fact a guitar magazine. I want to make sure guitarists get the most out of these reviews. I have to say, I'm actually really impressed with the way these mics perform, specifically the Myrtle. It has a really classic kind of character that I recognize from recordings, especially Southern rock recordings for some reason. It has a little bit of that kind of vibe about it. It's very, very cool indeed. Now, the next performance we're going to take a listen to is a vocal, and I've chosen to use a Shure Beta 58 as the reference mic here, because these microphones are intended to be used both in the studio and live, and they have absolutely excellent feedback rejection qualities. You can wind them up crazy loud and get like a feedback-free performance, even on a loud stage, which is very cool. So to this end, we're going to explore how these microphones perform as live vocal microphones, because I mean they look the business as well. So if you, you know, throw one of these up on your stage, people are going to be intrigued in what you're doing before you even hit the stage. They're going to see this microphone and go, man, that looks amazing. So let's take a listen to how a vocal performs, my vocal that is, on a Beta 58, then on the Myrtle, and then on the Louise.
How do I feel when my love went astray? And how do I feel at the end of the day? Now, how do I feel when my love went astray? And how do I feel at the end of the day? Now, how do I feel when my love went astray? And how do I feel at the end of the day?
So excellent studio quality condenser performance from both of these microphones, as you'd expect from handmade large diaphragm condensers. However, the very fact that you can take this level of performance on stage with you with no feedback issues and with these great looks to boot, that's a really, really cool thing in my estimation. And of course, the handling noise is going to be exceptionally low because they're both spring mounted in these rings. Now, for my own voice, I find my voice is a little dark sometimes and can struggle to cut, especially on a live stage. I preferred the sound of the Louise. However, for a female vocal, I'd be reaching for Myrtle for that kind of more warm character, especially with a very bright and present sounding voice. Now let's do one last comparison, and this time we're going to put these microphones in their sweet spot, which is about 6 inches away from a source, and we're going to listen to an acoustic guitar. Now, up until now, we've been close miking with both of these microphones, but they're really at their best when you start to bring them a little further away from the source. About 6 inches is a great sweet spot, but they can go as far back as you like, I suppose. They'd work really well as ambient mics on drums, for example. But 6 inches is a really good spot, and I found that to be a really nice place to mic a guitar from. So what we're going to do is we're going to throw up each of these mics in turn next to a Rode NT1A, which is an affordable large diaphragm condenser. Obviously not in the same price league as these microphones, but I chose the Rode because it's a mic that a lot of people are familiar with the sound of, because a lot of us have owned them or used them, and they're great sounding mics in their own right. So what we'll do is we'll throw these two mics up, the Rode and one of the Ear Trumpet Lab mics. We'll start with the Louise this time, and we'll listen to the same acoustic guitar performance through both mics, and we'll AB between them throughout the performance. Let's take a listen to the Louise versus the Rode first, and then we'll take a listen to Myrtle versus the Rode. So now we've heard how Louise performs in comparison to our reference mic. Let's compare Myrtle to the same reference mic, and I'll try my best to play the same thing. So as we said previously, a little bit of distance on these microphones is really where they start to shine, and there's some great representation of our acoustic guitar's character and chime and the sparkle from the strings. Really, really impressive performance from two very ruggedly made, and I have to say once again, absolutely gorgeous looking microphones. So there you go guys, in a nutshell, this has been Louise and Myrtle from Ear Trumpet Labs. My name is Nick Jennison for Guitar Interactive Magazine, and I will see you next time.